tea.
Like sand in the sea.
And the birds and the bees.
Like an oyster and a bird.
And a guy and a girl.
What have you got? You got a perfect match.
Okay, welcome back to the O10 Network and Studio 10's very special Perfect Match. Please welcome the star of the show, Mr. Greg Evans.
Thank you very much. Thank you, everybody in the studio. As someone famous once said, it's very nice to have a warm hand on your opening. Thank you very much for having me here today. It is a special edition of Perfect Match. It's the Studio 10 edition, the Bachelorette edition, where we're trying to find a lucky lady, the man of her dreams. Now, ladies and gentlemen, last night's Bachelorette, of course, saw the final, and wasn't it a heart-wrenching episode when Sasha won Sam's heart? It was beautiful. But, of course, what that means is that we now have some more eligible bachelors back on the market again. Yeah. And Celestina's now going to tell us, before we meet the bachelors, who our lovely lady is.
It's Denise from Queensland.
Denise from Queensland, who would have ever thought we'd end up doing this, Denise?
Exactly.
But I bet this is the first time you've ever been poised to win a prize that speaks, eh?
Oh.
Tell me, what are you looking for in your man, Denise?
A pulse.
A pulse, yes. Got a fair chance as long as he's breathing, eh?
Yeah, breathing, and but definitely a sense of humour. Shirley Jones said it before, sense
yes.
of humour.
Yes, I think so. I think laughter's very important. But we've got to get these bachelorettes, these lovely, spunky bachelorettes. Please tell us all about them.
First up, we have Alex. Alex, tell us a bit about yourself.
Well, I'm an English gentleman, a financial consultant, and I love handling figures.
He loves what?
I thought he said handling tickets.
What I thought he said, I love ham and eggs.
Somewhere in between, I think.
Contestant number two, what's your name and what do you do?
My name's Richie. I'm a rope access technician. I love talking about my feelings.
Talking about his feelings, did he say?
Yes, he did.
Feelings, I thought he said.
And thirdly, we have Bachelorette first runner-up, Michael. Michael, how will you steal Denise's heart?
Everything I did with Sam Frost, I'm going to do the opposite because that didn't work the first time.
Whoa. Some very interesting bachelors on the other side of the screen. Our beautiful single lady is locked in. Our bachelors
locked
are all
up.
Locked in. We're set to go and we will play the game in just a moment. Thank you very much and welcome back to Studio 10's Perfect Match with me, your host, Greg Evans, and with... Thank you very much. And we've got our three bachelorettes, Alex, Richie and Michael, all ready to try and win the hearts of this beautiful lady here. She's going weak at the knees. She's going weak at the knees. She's got sweaty palms and she's about to ask her first question. Take it away, Denise.
OK. Hi, boys. Do they know it's me?
No, they don't know it's me.
Oh, sorry.
Well, let's pretend they don't.
OK, they don't know it's me. Firstly, what do most girls say you have too much of?
Well, if that's a me, I hear that I have too much testosterone and that's why my hair's falling out. But if I had to say anything, Denise, I think you should find out for yourself.
Ooh. You cheeky chappy.
Yeah. Contestant number two, what do you have too much of?
I have too many sayings. I cool sticks, cool bananas. Yeah, way too much personality.
And bachelorette number three.
People tell me I've got too much competition. Have a look at these studs. Oh. These guys are on point.
See, you're in a pretty much no-lose situation because they
I
are all hunky-spunks.
They're in the losing situation.
Of those three answers, which one tickles your fancy?
I think testosterone.
Denise, please ask your next question to the bachelors. Right.
What's the most unusual place that you've had a date?
I would have to say the last girl I was seeing.
The most unusual place you've had a date? Number one?
Okay, The most unusual place I had a date was the last girl I was seeing. She took me in a topless aeroplane, which was rather dramatic. And then she locked me in a cage full of insects. So, you know, a little bit extravagant, but I wasn't going to say no.
They were butterflies.
And number two, the most unusual place you've ever had a date.
I went to a bowling club. I dressed up as an 80-year-old man and started breakdancing.
And number three.
The most unusual date I had was in New Zealand, sitting in a spring with about 100 cameras and about 50 crew watching my every move. So that was pretty weird.
Okay,
we had a date there.
Yeah, sitting in the spring.
Wow.
What was he in the mattress? Or I don't know what he's.
I'm going towards. Have we finished?
No. Which of those answers did you like?
I liked the cage one, but I like the first one.
Which was number one. Our match with number one being beautiful. And your last question, please. Final question tonight.
Okay, then. What do you think of the last girl that you dated?
Girl I dated, she was a gentle and beautiful creature, but I felt like she might have been seeing a few other guys on the side. So.
Number two, the last girl that you dated.
The last girl I dated is an absolute sweetheart, breath of fresh air, and she broke my heart.
Oh.
And finally, number three, tell us about the last girl you dated. What did you think about it?
The last girl I dated, she made me walk up the longest hill after I had my heart torn out. And the least she could do was send a car down to get me.
Right, you've heard all of their answers. Now another match. Rack
well,
city,
number three city. Sounds tired, so he'd fit really well with me.
Yeah. Don't want any heart attacks or anything. The way I figure it, she had a match with each of those three. Two with number one. Two with number one.
He's the financial advisor, isn't he?
He is.
Yeah, that'll do.
Two with number one, one with number three, none with number two. Who are you going to pick?
Number two. Number one.
Number one! Number one, come on through.
Take your card.
Number one.
Wait till I take my pill.
Wait till he takes his.
Here he comes. There he is.
So beautiful to be here with you.
Beautiful it is. Let's come over to our very own Dexter, live here in the studio, ladies and gentlemen. Who was the perfect match?
Jeepers creepers, you've got a compatibility score of 71% with Alex.
Question? You were 100% right, 71% with the financial man.
Really?
This is going to go very good.
Thanks, Dexter. Wow.
All right, we can collect all the money and make a deposit. Just absolutely fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much, Denise. Thank you, Dexter.
Thanks
for having some fun with us, and we'll be back with more Studio 10 after the break.